No matter whether you like it or not, you, and of course also I, have to vacuum our apartments from time to time. And honestly speaking, without pushing German stereotypes too much, I love to do that, because I love the cleanliness. But what I don't love is when my battery-powered vacuum abruptly dies on me, because I forgot charging it up the night before. If that happens, I can forget vacuuming, because the tiny power supply the vacuum came with takes several hours to charge it up. So I obviously had to come up with a solution, and what immediately came to my mind was my obsession with Makita power tools, which utilize a battery pack that you can just plug in and recharge separately anytime you like. So the question is, can we combine such a battery pack with my vacuum and thus increase its runtime to basically endlessly? Let's find out! This video is sponsored by Altium. If you're looking for professional PCB designer software that can pretty much do everything regarding PCB design, then the Altium Designer is for you. And if you are a beginner who's just curious, you can try the software out as well without a guilty conscience, because by following the link in the video description, you can do that completely for free, and maybe get hooked using it. So why not give it a try? First off, let me give you an overview of my vacuum. As you can see, it consists of one smaller portable unit with all the electronics inside and one bigger adapter shell into which the smaller unit can be clicked in order to turn it into a proper, fully sized vacuum. Great concept if you ask me, but what is not great is the charging time of the system, which I measured to be around 3 hours and 50 minutes. The reason is, like previously mentioned, that the power supply can only deliver 500 milliamps, and considering the time the charging required, it seems like the internal battery pack should come with a capacity of around 2000 milliamp hours. To confirm that, I removed the front cap of the vacuum as well as all the screws I found in the housing, and then used a bit of force to crack everything open, which was actually way easier to do than I thought. And before we have a closer look at the electronics, let's quickly check the battery pack, which as theorized comes with a capacity of 2 amp hours. But anyway, next I examined all the electronic parts of the vacuum, and it was quite fascinating to discover how simple this system really is. The heart of it is this circuit board, based around a custom programmed STM microcontroller, to which the vacuum motor, battery pack, charge wires and switch with notification LED is connected. If we draw that up, the simplified system should look something like this. Now the circuit board basically manages charging up the battery pack as well as powering the motor with it if the power switch is on. Of course, it also turns off the motor if the battery pack reaches an undervoltage threshold value, which you know bothered me before. So next, to investigate further, I removed the positive wire from the motor in order to hook up my multimeter in current measuring mode in between. And it seems like the current draw of the motor is around 7.5 amps at max. And since we are aware of the capacity of the battery pack, we can calculate the runtime, which should be around 17 minutes, at least in theory. Because the battery pack is of course years old, and even though it was being used pretty ideally with a temperature measuring probe and balancing wires connected to the PCB, which basically guarantee that no big voltage difference between the individual cells would develop over time, I was certain that the overall capacity dropped a bit. To confirm that, I measured the capacity with a lithium ion charger slash discharger. And it seems like the actual capacity is around 1850 milliamp hours. And considering that with bigger current draws, the capacity drops even more, I would say that a realistic runtime is only around 10 minutes. But we can easily double this value with my 5 amp hour Makita battery pack. But how can we integrate it electrically into the vacuum system? For that, we firstly need such an adapter, that you can get for cheap from the internet. By connecting it to the battery, we can use its voltage to power things, which seems to be around 20 volts, which, of course, coincidentally, is in the same voltage range as the internal battery pack of the vacuum, because they're both 18 volt battery packs. So according to the voltage, the batteries are compatible. But what about the current draw? For that, I connected the Makita battery pack to constant load, which was able to draw the maximum current of 7.5 amps continuously without a problem. That means the Makita battery pack is compatible, and now we simply need to find a way to disconnect the internal battery pack and connect the Makita one if it is plugged in, and then switch back to the internal one if the Makita pack gets disconnected. The solution is of course such a relay, that comes with two internal toggle switches, can handle 10 amps at 28 volts DC, and needs 12 volts for switching. Here's the way we have to connect it to the system, and all it does is normally connecting the internal battery pack to the circuit boards. But if the Makita pack is plugged in, the relay coil gets powered, and thus the switches now connect the Makita pack to the circuit board, and we can continue vacuuming. The only missing information was the value of this resistor, but after doing a bit of testing, I calculated that we should be good with two 100 ohm ones connected in parallel. So next, I built up the electrical system I just described for testing, by snipping a couple of wires and soldering them in place. And as soon as that was done, you can see that the vacuum still works just fine without the external battery pack. And if we connect it, the relay turns on and we can power the vacuum with it. At least for a couple of seconds. Yep, it seems like the circuit does not like my external power idea, and thus shuts off pretty quickly. At this point, I thought that the circuit didn't like reading the balance wire voltages of the internal almost drained battery pack while being powered by way higher external voltage, which in correlation does not make sense. But that was actually not the problem. Instead, the missing ground connection between the external and internal battery pack that lets the balance wire voltage float in the air was the problem. Luckily though, that was easily fixable by creating one common ground, which I did for testing with an alligator clip wire and later with a bigger Vago terminal. And as you can see, now everything works perfectly fine, exactly how I imagined it in my head. So time to rip the electrical wiring apart for now, and find a place to mount the adapter plate to the vacuum. And no, the flat bottom side was not an option, because that is not accessible when the vacuum goes into transformer mode. That means I had to settle for an uneven side, and thus started the mounting process by firstly removing the top piece of the adapter. After then drilling a 5mm hole in the middle for the wires, I drilled another 4mm hole in the upper right corner, which I used as a template to drill the first hole into the vacuum's enclosure. Next, I used one M4 bolt, washers and nuts to secure the adapter to the vacuum, and continued by drilling a second mounting hole and using that in the same way as the first one. At this point, the adapter was fairly nicely secured, but to make sure it will never get ripped off, I continued by doing something I haven't done in ages: plastic welding. Yes, with a bit of heat and special ABS plastic welding sticks, you can easily create some very sturdy connection between plastic pieces. As you can also see with this tray I plastic welded years ago. And after sanding everything a bit and giving it all a new layer of paint, it was time to put the adapter back together and repeat the electrical wiring in almost the same way as before, with the only difference that this time I was using shrinking tubes to prevent electrical shorts. And as soon as the soldering was done, I hot glued the relay to a free spot in the vacuum, created the common ground, did one final test without external power and of course with external power, and ultimately put everything back together, which to my own surprise was easier to do than I thought. And just like that, the project was complete. And the vacuum, of course, still works perfectly fine, while now featuring a practically indefinite runtime, since I got two external battery packs I can switch between. With that being said, I hope you enjoyed this project and learned something along the way. If so, consider supporting me through Patreon. As always, don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. Stay creative, and I will see you next time!